Are you using Airtable and you're concerned about the new Airtable pricing that was just recently announced? Or maybe you're trying to build a third-party application and you're trying to figure out what your costs are gonna be month over month for all your different users. Well, in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down Airtable's pricing as it relates to people who are using Sofdr to build their front end. So if that's of interest to you, stick around. And let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. This video is going to be breaking down those new Airtable pricing changes as it relates to people who are using or are interested in using Sofdr. Actually, we find that there's a big new demand for Sofdr right now because as Airtable has become more expensive, we've had more and more clients reaching out saying, what would it look like to reimagine my application in Sofdr? Why? Well, in many cases, it becomes much cheaper. If you're not wanting to pay for all of these different Airtable users just to edit a little bit of data here and there, Sofdr allows you to build external portals or web applications that run from your Airtable data, and the end user can still update information just like they would in an Airtable interface. The key takeaway here is that they won't be able to be builders inside of Airtable. But before we get into the heart of this video, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. If you are newer to no-code, or if you just need a refresher, the key building block of all no-code tools is automation. And I have a free training set up. Doesn't matter what automation tool you're using, you're gonna get a ton of value from this training and it'll help you leverage automation and understand the key building blocks. Check out the training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll send it to you immediately and you can get rolling right there. But without further ado, let's hop on into things. I wanna start off by pointing out that here Sofdr is already addressing these issues. There are a lot of unknowns. They're calling all of this out, but they are being as transparent as possible. Frankly, that's the kind of leadership I love to see. So I'm excited that they are taking this perspective. So not too long ago, Merriam, the CEO and one of the co-founders of Sofdr, went ahead and published this to their blog. They're saying, hey, listen, we know that Airtable's pricing changes have startled some folks. We've already helped over 200,000 Airtable users build things here in Sofdr. Let's talk about how it's gonna impact you. Not sure about this whole thing. No, I'm kidding. I actually love Dan. He's great. If you have not already, please consider following him. The more people speaking about Airtable and helping educate others, in my opinion, the better. But the important part is where we get down here. We're talking about the big pieces that are being changed in Airtable's new pricing. That is, the introduction of a new plan, that upgraded business plan. They've now gotten rid of the plus plan, pro and team plans, which were $20 and $10 plans respectively, have been bundled together. The cheapest Airtable plan is now $20 per user. And that is now called the team plan. Also, we're getting a call here, a limitation to our API calls. This will impact Sofdr users, but more on that in a moment. We have changes in syncing and storage and changes in automation. So, Sofdr's put together this great blog post. I recommend going through it and checking it out if you are curious about all these different things. One thing I do want to highlight is that we don't really have an answer to how much we are using API calls right now. So Sofdr mentions right here, they don't expose API limits on their own, but they don't have special permissions to get around Airtable API limits, as mentioned above. So Airtable has API limits that are gonna go into effect, and Sofdr is gonna be subject to those limitations. But here's the thing, we don't really know what our API utility is quite yet, and really it's per workspace in Airtable. It doesn't matter if you're paying 1 or 10 seats, your API limit is gonna be the same. Also note that the quota is shared across all integrations, meaning that it's not just Sofdr that might be talking to your Airtable and interacting with the API. You could also be sending data to Make or Zapier or any other number of third-party tools as well. So Sofdr has put together an awesome, awesome setup here. If you need to talk to somebody over there, you can schedule with them right here and get better understanding of how this might impact you. Again, we don't yet know what the API calls look like, because Airtable doesn't show us how much of that API limitation we're using yet. They've promised to release something soon that lets us get some insight into how much of those API calls we are actually utilizing. This is going to be really important information to help you determine what Airtable plan you need to be on. Because, as mentioned, depending on the tier that you're on, if you're paying higher amounts, you get more API calls. If you're on a free plan, it's capped out pretty darn low. And even that first paid tier, that team plan, we're not really sure if it has a lot of API calls or not, because again, we have no transparency into how much we're actually using. All right, now this all being said, this is well and good, but what does it mean for you when you're actually looking at adding users to Airtable or maybe considering building another application in Sofdr? Well, I put together a pretty easy calculator here. This is not something I'm going to be sharing. The calculations are really simple. This is for demonstrative purposes only, but I'm going to go through a couple of examples here and talk about how you would receive different bills either from Airtable or from Sofdr based on where you leveraged the different tools. So let's get into it. So let's imagine that you are on the cheapest Airtable paid plan. That is a team plan on an annual basis. Okay, that is the cheapest plan that prices at $20 per user. Now, when I say per user, I do want to point out that if you have read-only users in Airtable, they are not going to ever be charged an amount, at least not that we know of. Now, that being said, sometimes you have builders, people who are actually creating stuff in Airtable. They're the ones building your databases, admin to your Airtable accounts, all of that. But most of the Airtable users for our clients fall in what we would consider editors. They're not building stuff in Airtable. No, they're just accessing the interfaces. They're just interacting with the data on a day-to-day basis. So those are the folks that you are going to pay for on an Airtable plan. But if you instead build some sort of web application in Sofdr, you could remove those people from your Airtable account and instead give them login access to Sofdr, and you would save a lot of money on your Airtable bill. Let's take an example. We've got the team plan, annual basis. Okay, let's imagine that we have 10 users in our organization. I'm gonna say that one of them is a builder and 8 of them are editors and 1 is read-only, okay? So I've got, again, 1 builder, 8 editors, 1 read-only for a total of 10 users. Okay, well, quick and easy math right here. Airtable's pricing would be $180 per month. Now remember, I chose the annual option, so you'd actually have to multiply this by 12 and pay it all at once. But let's imagine that we divided that payment over months just so we can compare apples to apples. Airtable's gonna cost me $180, whereas with Sofdr, I would actually wind up paying $159. So I'd save a little bit of money every month. Now why is that? Well, let's take a look at my formulas here. You notice that if I'm on the Airtable pricing plan, I'm gonna have to multiply the number of builders, anybody building in Airtable, multiply that by the cost per user per month, and then add that to the number of editors also multiplied by the cost per user per month. So in our example here, I've got 1 builder and 8 editors. That's a total of 9 people multiplied by 20. That's $180. That's how we come up with the amount that we would be spending with Airtable. But if we're looking at Sofdr, well, what are we doing? Now, I've assumed that we are on an upgraded Sofdr plan. In fact, I could be on a $49 a month Sofdr plan and I would save even more money. But because I personally prefer that $139 plan, I put that in here. I just hard-coded that. So that's my Sofdr cost. Does not matter how many different users are accessing my application, but I could have the exact same numbers here, but I'm only going to pay for that $139 Sofdr cost and however many builders I have in Airtable. Note that these 8 people, if I went with a web application in Sofdr, they would not actually be on my Airtable plan. I would have 1 person on my Airtable plan, the rest of them all on Sofdr, and they would be able to log in. Sofdr is not gonna charge me for the number of users I have. Their fee, their price for their software is fixed regardless of the number of users. So this might sound like it's too good to be true. Let's actually flip in and take a look at Sofdr pricing. Scrolling on down on the Sofdr page, Here we are. I'm imagining I'm at that $139 a month for the professional plan. I love this one, but truth be told, that basic plan is going to get you most of what you need. Now notice, actions. This is where we can take actions like updating, deleting records, triggering webhooks, etc. This is available even on the free softer plan. So you don't have to be on that professional plan in order to get the ability to give your users permission to edit data. Now there are some action permissions that you need to take into account when picking your softer plan. Here we are, for example, this is basic permissioning here for the professional plan. So it's the same permission for all logged in users is granted. Whereas if I upgrade all the way up to the business plan, well then I get different permissions for each custom user group. So if you've got a lot of different users accessing your softer plan and they all have different roles and responsibilities and qualifications and things that you want to let them do, well then you need to probably be on that business plan so that you can get really granular with how they are going to edit different things within your application. But that being said, look at this. The app users, unlimited for every tier, right? Internal users, well, these are the people who are building your applications. These are the people on your team actually building them, not using them. External users is what you're caring about, and you can have up to 5,000 per app on that middle tier, 10,000 on that business tier. So now that we see that this is what's available inside of Softr, let's flip back in and imagine some other scenarios back in our spreadsheet. Let's say I was actually on a more expensive Airtable plan, the business tier, for example, and maybe I'm on a monthly plan. Truth be told, this is what I want to move our organization to. I really love the functionality at this tier, but I don't need everybody being a builder in that environment. So maybe for my team, and we've got about 20 to 25 developers on any given day. Well, let's say we've got a 25 total user count here for our app that we're thinking about building, but only three of them are going to be actively building in Airtable. Maybe everybody else is an editor. 22 people who need to update this information. I don't have anybody on read-only, right? So what happens? Well, let's go ahead and drag these formulas down and take a look at what our price difference is. If I've got 25 people all with Airtable login access at $54 a month each, I'm spending $1,300 a month to get those people up and running in Airtable. This is where building a web application in Softr becomes almost a no-brainer for this team. Instead of having all these people logged into Airtable who frankly don't need to be building stuff in Airtable, instead I'm just going to give them a web application in Softr to access. So what's my price wind up being? $301. Why? Spending about $140 on Softr itself plus about $160 on Airtable users because I only have three builders at $54 each in Airtable. So my Airtable cost is $160, and then I'm spending $140 in Softr. So my total pricing, if I were to build something in Softr, is $301, which saves me over $1,000 a month. And for a small organization of this size, you know, my size is 25 different users. Are you kidding me? This is a no-brainer. So what does this mean for you? Well, if you need help moving your stuff over into a softer web application so that you can reduce the number of Airtable users that you have on your account, hit us up. We've done this many, many times as an organization, and we would love to help you too. I know we went fast in this video. I hope we didn't cover too much or scare anyone too much, but leave any questions or comments you have below this video. And in the meantime, keep on building.